Perfect.
How did machine learning, if you don't know what machine learning is, it is an artificial intelligence that's within a computer that people program into it to allow the computer to actually make its own decisions and learn brand new objects or ways of thinking. So first we're going to start off with some examples of what programming actually is and how they come up with these ideas of things like Google, where they have a search engine, and things like Watson, where you can come up with his own answers for Jeopardy. So to begin with, we start off with a regular car. The whole car itself is what's called a class, and your methods will be things like refuel or get more fuel or set your speed than you're going to be at when you're driving or get the speed from what your pedometer is saying. Attributes, which are actually called instance variables, are what your fuel capacity is and what your max speed can be in the car. So we're going to be looking at some main examples of machine learning is overloading and overriding. Overloading is just making multiple methods that do similar actions, but they're different in a very slight way so that you can make very specific changes to your classes. Overriding just basically extends off of your initial method and makes it perform better or carries it further into the class. And as you can see here, we actually have a lot of different types of artificial intelligence. But really all we're going to be learning about is what's up here, which is machine learning. Most of the time in machine learning, you'll learn it in some sort of robotics. You won't really be able to see machine learning in small search engines. You'll see later. So we have on the far left side, we have your initial primate. This is their source of, it's a play on evolution. So at the beginning, you have a very rudimentary beginning level an object that is entirely reactive. It will only get you information, it will only set information for itself. Eventually it'll start to learn new things and give you maybe what your prediction will be for next month's quota, maybe in the stock market or something like that. If you think that, you know, Apple's stock is going to go up, your machine will start predicting that for you. The next step is something that is done in Excel. You'll see it a lot. It's very statistical based, and it starts to learn a little bit further into the future, and will start predicting things, and still in a sort of reactive phase, but it will still learn a lot. And the next stage kind of revolves more around like the hierarchy of what you're doing. So like it starts off with stock markets, then it goes into what your finances are going to be like in the next quarter. And it'll calculate everything all together and be able to predict more and more. As you move on, you'll realize that it predicts even further than the human brain can do anything for that matter, because the machine will use 100% of its capacity while the human brain only uses about 12. And the machine is using its brain for specifically stock markets and financials. But that's the boring stuff. So as you can see, we'll have a normal human learns from experience. This machine will learn from experience from messing up or what you tell it's messing up in. And something like a rover that you put on Mars or what we put on the moon simply follows instructions from people, and it will not discover anything new from learning on its own. Some examples, we have Tesla, which is a self-driving car in the foreseeable future. We have Apple, which is a personal assistant, something like Siri. It learns from people's previous questions and puts it back into their database where they can say, give you a specific answer for it. And it actually learns on its own, so it'll give you new answers every single time. Like you'll see if you ask it for a riddle, it'll give you a riddle. And they can input more and more riddles into it. But something like Google is entirely search-based. It will give you a bunch of keywords, and those keywords will be put into the database and will search through a very, very large database, the biggest in the world, and we'll give you an answer for that. Amazon is entirely a product recommendation. It's a lot like a search, except it has rating systems and it has previous user ratings. So that way you can, it will tell you what you previously searched for and what you might want in the foreseeable future. And Netflix gives you movie recommendations. You'll see it all the time, recommended movies. That works entirely by genre and rating. You can see that a lot. And this is actually Watson. Watson is a supercomputer that performed on Jeopardy. And he actually started off very, very, very badly. He only got maybe 2% of the questions right. And now he improved his database. The programmers for Watson actually inputted only a few items from specifically history. And Watson actually learned from it and started developing its own database. And eventually it came up with, I think it had around like an 80% success rate in all questions. So we're going to talk about three different types of machine learning. These are actually all the linear versions. I will be explaining some more in-depth versions later. There's supervised, which actually you label all the items that you are going to be putting into your input, and it will give you an output with those labeled items and say, these are your items, these are my items, I'll give you what I have. And then unsupervised, you give it no labels, you give it no memory or anything, you don't tell it anything at all, and it will give you an output and a new output the next time that is comparable to the last one. So it has generations. Reinforcement, how it works is the input is put in by you, you're labeling it, and then it gives you an output. Then you correct that output and put it into the next generation. So it's kind of like reinforced learning. So it would be kind of like if you get a question wrong on a math test, and then you go to your teacher, and your teacher explains it to you and says, this is why you got it wrong, and then you would learn. There is a difference between machine learning and statistics. Machine learning is entirely, you do not know what the next generation is going to do. Statistics gives you a prediction of what the next generation may do. So, for instance, a machine would give you an output something like, you have 60% profit this quarter, you will have 60% profit next quarter. But for statistics, it will give you, this is your profit this quarter, your next profit will have a 90% chance of getting this profit next quarter. And you can actually see the machine learning is getting closer and closer to statistics. In fact, it's overlapping just a little bit in here. Machine learning is getting so much like statistics that they're actually conjoining some subjects in college, so that you can learn statistics and machine learning at the same time, so they'll actually combine those subjects.
What's KDD? I'm sorry.
What?
What's KDD on that?
KDD, I'm not sure what that is. Most of these I don't really know about. I'm still trying to figure out neural computing. I haven't figured out KDD yet. I know data mining is just finding information within databases. KDD, I think, is like a larger version of the database. So we have a bunch of different algorithms that go along with machine learning. Many different ways of getting a machine to learn something new. One of them is a decision tree algorithm. You give it a choice between two different choices, and it gives you that output, and allows, and then you give it a new decision, and it will make that decision in the future, depending on if you say it's right or wrong. Regularization algorithms happen when you give it a new decision, and it branches off of that decision, and if later on you say, oh, I think this is wrong, it'll come up with a new decision, and will allow you to improve that learning capability later. Instance-based algorithms, you start off with your first decision, and the computer actually starts making its own decisions later on, and it'll branch off into other categories. Regression algorithms, we have To start off with, you have like, we start up here, and it comes down and we have our first decision. And you say, I don't like this decision. Your computer learns from it, and it actually goes backwards and says, this decision wasn't quite right. I'm going to make a better decision. And then that better decision overlaps the previous decision. For the posterior and prior, Bayesian algorithms are actually very complicated. Your posterior is actually the portion where you say this has been correct in the past, and your prior is saying, oh yeah, this was like sort of right, but I don't want that anymore. Clustering algorithms would be something like a, like if you had a scatter plot and you said, I want this decision and this decision to happen in the future. But you have to say that, so there's not a lot of machine learning in that one. That's more like you saying, I want this and that. Your association rule learning algorithms, you can say, I want this point on the graph, and it will give you a new point. This would be used a lot more in stock markets and graphing. Really boring stuff. So we have, finally, we have artificial neural network algorithms. This one is the one that is used by Google. This is the biggest one that you can use because it has very little memory, but a lot of processing power. So it can do a lot, but you don't need to input a lot. And this one, so you just give it a decision, and it'll branch off that decision and give you up to 3 million new decisions. So this is deep learning. We'll actually be looking at a video of this later. I won't go too far into that. Dimensional reduction algorithms, that basically takes, well, you can see it's a three-dimensional object back into a two-dimensional object. So it's basically reducing the computer's ability to make a decision. That way you can narrow it down and tell it, I only want this and this decision to happen in the future. Ensemble algorithms, these all actually, you give it, this one branches off the previous one, here, instance based. So these branch off here, and then you get the decision back, and you say, oh, I don't really want this anymore. I'm going to make a better decision so that I can allow this machine to be better in the future generation. And here is the data here. It starts off here with actually a
color blinds of different
colors. He's playing Mario, and Mario is entirely controlled by you. You can see all the buttons on the right up here, and this took 24 hours for the machine to learn the entire level and get it entirely correct on that try. It took 34 generations, 14 species and 14 genomes. That just basically means that it went through the 34th generation because it passed a certain point. Based upon past experiences. But this was the one that actually made it. So you can see here, it shows like where the neural, this is the deep learning, this is where the neural patterns kind of came into play. And the boxes in the middle here are actually where the linkages, where they say this was right at this time specifically. And it keeps them locked in place so that it's not unpressed. So you can actually see this moving to the right almost the entire time. And it finally won. And to conclude, I really do enjoy machine learning. I think everybody should learn machine learning because it's very important to understand what it is, and it helps you understand search engines and what you need to search for in future generations.
So. Awesome. All right. Sam, before you leave up there, if someone were interested in this, where would you have them start? Where should they start?
MachineLearningMastery.com.
Okay. And then what did you like and not like about Genius Hour?
Genius Hour, it was a lot of fun to learn it. I don't think we had enough time in class. I actually had to do a lot of this at home. But because we only had like an hour in class, it took a long time for me to boot up my computer and get this all done. I actually have to learn a lot of this.
Awesome.